Konnichiwa minasan, welcome back to the channel. This is Pradeep Sharma and today we will learn how to make te form in Japanese verbs. How to make te form. We have already learned the mass form of Japanese verbs and dictionary form of Japanese verbs. So today we will learn how to make te form. Let's start with the group third, and we all know that there are only two verbs in group third. First is shimasu and second one is kimasu. They are written in romaji as well. So shimasu means to do and kimasu means to come. And te form of the group third verbs is fix as usual. So shimasu te form would be shite and kimasu te form would be kite. So this is the group third. Now let's move to the second group. In group second, this is also simple. In group second, here we will masu remove and add te. So masu will be replaced with te in group second. So now let's have a look on examples so that we can clarify. Here the first example is tabemasu. We can see here it is written in romaji as well. So tabemasu, this masu would be replaced with this te, so it would become tabete, which means to eat. And in mimasu, you can see here mimasu, this masu, this masu would be replaced with te, so it would be pronounced as mite. In te form, mimasu means to see, to look. And our final is abimasu. This is an exception, that's why I have written. We can all the things we can know in our last videos of dictionary form and the masu form. I'll drop the link in description. Abimasu means to take for shower, and this masu would be replaced with this te. So abimasu would be recorded as abite in te form. This was the group second. Now let's come to the group first. Te form of groups first would be changed according to the dictionary form of group first verbs. So you will have to know how to make dictionary form to change the te form of group first verbs. Te form will be according to dictionary form. I'll drop the link in description for dictionary form. Verbs which are having u, tsu, ru at the end after making the dictionary form would change with te. Te, this is double T. Te. Let me show with the example. Here our first example is kaimasu. Kaimasu, written in romaji as well. Kaimasu means to buy. If you will change it in dictionary form, then it would be become kau. This u, this is the u, it will pronounce as u. So if we are pronounced here, it comes u comes, so it will be changed with te. This te, so it will become katte. Katte, kaimasu, kau, katte. Now let's move to next example. Here is our second example, which is machimasu. Machimasu, if you will change it in dictionary form, machimasu means to hold, to carry. If you will change it in dictionary form, then it would become matsu, and this tsu having at the end will change with te. So it will become matte. Machimasu, matsu, matte. And our final example is kaerimasu, which means to return home. So if you will change it in dictionary form, then it would become kaeru. This ru will change with te, so in te form it will become kaette. Kaerimasu, kaeru, katte, kaette. Now let's move to the second line. Here verbs which are having nu, bu, mu at the end. Nu, bu, mu at the end will change with nde, nde, nde. Let's take some examples. Manabimas, manabimas, which means to study. So if you will make dictionary form, then it will become manabu, this bu. So it will, the form of manabimas will become manande, manande. Yomimas, one more example. Yomimas, dictionary form of yomimas will be yomu, and here it is having, here it is having mu at the end, so te form of yomimas will be yonde, yonde. Te form of yomimas will be yonde. Yomimas means to read. And of final is shinimas, which means to die. So dictionary form of shinimas would be shinu, and here it is having nu at the end, this nu, then it will, the form of shinimas will become shinde. Now let's move to the next step. If verbs are having su at the end after changing in dictionary form, then these would be changed with shite. So hanashimas, here we are taking hanashimas. Hanashimas means to speak. So dictionary form of hanashimas would be hanasu, which is having su at the end. So te form of hanashimas would be hanashite, hanashite. Here if we are having gu at the end after changing in dictionary form, if we are having gu, then it will be changed with ide. Gu would be changed with ide. So let's take an example. Oyogimas, oyogimas, which means to swim. If you are changing dictionary form, then it will be pronounced as oyogu. It would become oyogu. Then it is having gu at the end, so te form of oyogimas will be oyoide. Oyoide means to swim. Here if you are having ku at the end, this is the final one, ku at the end after changing in dictionary form, then it will become ite, like kakimas, which means to write. Dictionary form of kakimas would be kaku. So here it is having ku at the end, so te form of kakimas would be kaite. So guys, and there is an exception also, ikimas. Ikimas, dictionary form of ikimas would be iku, this means to go. But te form of ikimas would be itte. Technically it should be ite, like it should be having ite at the end, but this is an exception, so it will become iku itte. I hope you guys have understood that how to make te form. Then please drop your comments in comment box. Please do like the video, share the video with your friends, and subscribe the channel as well. Thank you. Bye bye. Jai Mata. Arigato. Gozaimasu.